I now have 17 mechanical watches in my collection. And as I look at those watches, and as I've been buying those watches, I've been asking myself a couple of questions. A couple of questions have been in the back of my head. And those questions are, do I need to get these watches serviced? When do I need to get these watches serviced? And how much is it going to cost me to get all these 17 watches serviced? Hello, you're watching James. My name's James, you're watching me, and I am talking about watches. And I'm particularly talking today about mechanical watches and the servicing of them and what is actually the truth behind them. Because now that I have 17 watches in my collection that are mechanical watches that are going to need to be serviced, I need to sort of have a better understanding of, do they need to be serviced? When do they need to be serviced? And it is quite important to me to know how much it is going to cost me to get these watches serviced. Now, I do need to say that I am not a watchmaker. I'm not an expert about watches. I'm not an engineer. I don't have that technical knowledge about mechanical things and mechanical watches specifically. So please keep that in mind. So today, I'm going to be talking about my own personal opinions about this. However, those personal opinions have been influenced by two big things. Firstly, because I love watches so much, because I am really enthusiastic about them, I put a lot of energy into learning about watches and mechanical movements. So I've done a lot of research and put a lot of time and energy into learning about that. Secondly, because I love watches so much, I ask questions about watches. And whenever I've spoken to watchmakers, multiple watchmakers, I ask them lots of questions. I ask them lots of questions beyond the simple question of, do I need to get my watch serviced? Or how much is that service going to cost me? So keeping that in mind that these are my personal opinions, but also keeping in mind that these opinions are based on asking questions from people who know what they're talking about and by putting the time and energy into the research about servicing of watches. And when I do ask watchmakers, or when I do type into Google, how often do I need to get my mechanical watch serviced? There is a general sort of universal answer. It's a bit of a boring answer, and there's a lot more to it than this, but the general advice that you get is that you should be servicing your mechanical watches every 5 years. Now, keep that in mind, but it's not exactly the answer that I'm looking for, because there are other things that surround this that are more important. Because I ask further questions like, well, does it make any difference between wearing a watch every single day versus a watch that's sitting in my watch box and only being worn occasionally in rotation? Because then the answer then changes. Well, it changes a little bit, because when you talk to watchmakers about this, they will often tell you that if you wear a watch every single day, if you wear a mechanical watch every single day, then it is pretty likely that you should be getting it serviced every 5 years, if not even slightly sooner, around 4 years. Now this makes sense. This is pretty obvious to me, because if you're wearing a watch every single day, it means it's being used and it's moving and the parts are possibly wearing out and the oils are possibly being moved around. But more than that, if you wear one watch every single day, really you should be looking after it. So get that watch serviced regularly. However, that doesn't really relate to me. What relates to me is that I have a larger collection. I have a collection that I wear all of them sort of periodically. I spread them out. I have a sort of collection of watches that I wear all of them, which means they are all worn every day. It means that some watches are worn once a week, twice a week, some are worn possibly only once a month. And how does that affect the servicing requirements of those watches? Do they still need to be serviced every 5 years? Or can I push that servicing out a little bit more? And the answer that I get from watchmakers is that yes, you can push it out a little bit. In fact, they seem to say, and again, it's a generalized answer over the few people that I've spoken to, is around 7 to 8 years. You can push it out a little bit further, but you should still be regularly servicing those movements. Now, on that note, I do want to say, if you have a mechanical watch in your watch box that you hardly ever wear, well, you should absolutely still have the movement inside that watch moving occasionally. You should wear that watch every sort of 4 to 6 weeks, or at least wind it up every 4 to 6 weeks, because you don't want the mechanical movement just sitting idle for years on end. It's not particularly good for it. So if you do have one of those watches in your watch box, just wind up occasionally. Just wear it occasionally, just to give it a little bit of movement. You don't want it sitting idle for that particular sort of long length of time. And I guess on that note, I think I would just want to mention something about watch winders, because it's a question that gets asked a lot about, should you get a watch winder? And I'm going to say to you right now that the answer to that question is no. I don't think you should. In fact, a lot of watchmakers have said the same thing when I've asked this question, should you get a watch winder? The answer is no, because if you have a watch in a watch winder, it's going to be sort of being worn as much as if you're actually wearing that watch every single day, which means you're going to have to get it serviced more often. And a watch doesn't have to be working continuously. It is okay for it to stop. It's just that you want it working occasionally, like every 4 to 6 weeks. So I don't think a watch winder is a great idea. I think there's probably a few caveats to that, however. If you have a watch that has certain complications that are annoying to then reset all the time, possibly you should consider it. If you have a watch that you wear a lot and you just don't want it to stop, you don't want to have to reset it every time, then possibly have a watch winder. But in my opinion, personally, I actually don't think they're worthwhile having. Or at least it might be worthwhile having them, but not having the watches sitting in them all the time. Possibly have one just to use occasionally when it suits that watch or what you're doing with it at that time. Now, what I find confusing about this time frames of watch servicing is when I start looking on the websites of certain watch brands, because they don't stipulate 5 years specifically, or at least there are two other time frames that are listed often. In the more sort of high-end watches, luxury watches, I have seen on many websites them stipulate that your mechanical watch movement should be serviced every 3 years. I've seen this on quite a few websites. Why is that 3 years? On other websites, well, to be honest, there's one particular watch brand that stipulates it only needs to be serviced every 10 years. So why are some watch companies saying every 3 years? Why is this watch company saying every 10 years? And why are watchmakers saying every 5 years? Well, I'm not 100% sure, but I think I have an answer. I think some of these higher-end watches that are in COSC certifications that perhaps are a little bit more delicate, they have a lot more sort of number of parts inside them that could possibly go wrong more often, but what they're trying to do is keep them within sort of those COSC sort of specifications. They're saying get it serviced more often to ensure that that movement is healthy, to ensure that it is as accurate as they want that watch to be moving. Whereas this other brand that says every 10 years, well, they're not so worried about how it's running. They're not so worried about the delicate parts because the parts aren't that delicate. They're sort of built differently. They're built to be sort of withstand much more sort of wide ranges of accuracy, but also just be solid and just run continuously. And on that note, I want to say something about watch servicing, because for me, there's three elements to it. I know there's probably a lot more than that, but when I think about watch servicing, there's three elements. Firstly, the metal components of that watch movement. Those metal components are going to be moving around, they're going to be wearing out, they may get broken, there's little teeth that could be worn out, and little bits of metal can be then moved around the movement itself. So obviously, when you service a watch, you want it to get cleaned and assessed and looked at. That's an element. That makes sense to me. That's pretty obvious. The second element is the oils within the watch movement, the oils that are lubricating it. And when you talk about servicing of watches, and when you speak to people about servicing of watches, often they'll say that you need to get it regularly serviced because the oils dry out. But when you speak to watchmakers specifically about this question, they quite often say that they don't really dry out that quickly. They're certainly not drying out within 5 years. They're not even drying out within 10 years. And with better lubricants being used, they are lasting longer, which is why that one watch brand, when they say 10 years between service intervals, they're not worried about the oils. Obviously, the oils will eventually probably dry out or move around or possibly also get contaminated. So getting those lubricants changed on a semi-regular or regular basis is probably a good idea. But I don't think we need to be specifically worrying within short time frames about it disappearing and things starting to mesh together and not be lubricated properly. The third part, however, is sort of water tightness and seals. This is a pretty obvious one as far as I'm concerned, because rubber is only going to last a certain amount of time. If there's a rubber seal in there, that's going to degrade. It doesn't matter how good quality the watch is or how good quality the seal that is used, it's going to degrade. And if I'm using a watch with water resistance, if I'm going diving with it, if I'm going swimming with it, I certainly know if I hadn't had that watch serviced within a 10-year period, I would be a little bit nervous about putting that watch in water. So I keep that in mind as well. So they're the three elements I consider, and when I consider the time frames, they're the things that I'm talking about, and they're the things that I'm thinking about too. Now, with all that in mind, what am I doing with my watches? What am I doing with my 17 mechanical watch movements? Well, let's keep in mind, this is what I'm doing. If you are going to be servicing your watches and thinking about your watches, please put some more time and energy into learning about this, asking questions yourself. I just want to tell you what I'm doing with my watches. And in fact, I've actually grouped my mechanical watches into four separate groups. Firstly, there are watches in my watch collection that I'm never going to service. And there's a couple of reasons. There's sort of two specific reasons, actually. Firstly, is watches that aren't going to stay in my watch box long term. Watches that I come into my collection, I've bought, I've loved, I've enjoyed, I've worn, but then I've ended up selling. And the vast majority of those watches are less than 5 years old. Quite often I'm either buying them new or very near new, and they end up getting sold before it hits that sort of service period. In fact, on occasion, it will be an element or a reason why possibly I'm actually thinking about selling the watch. It's not normally the reason, but it is also in the back of my mind. So quite often, watches that fit into this category have already moved out of my collection before I even need to worry about servicing. However, there is a couple of watches that are in my collection long-term that I have no plans to service, and that is because I don't really wear them. They're in my collection for different reasons. They're in my collection for sort of personal reasons, and I have a connection to them, but they're not being worn. I'm not really worried about them running correctly or being watertight, so there's no real point for me to invest that money. So I'm happy for those watches to stay in my collection unserviced. The second category of watches that are in my collection when I think about servicing is watches that I'm basically going to wear, own, enjoy until they basically stop working or until they start having an issue. It is at that point I'm then going to go, okay, I'm now going to get these serviced or even have the watch movements replaced. And in this category, often this is watches that contain sort of more affordable movements. Watches that contain Seiko or Miyota movements. This is not just purely Seiko and Miyota movements, but these tend to be the watches that fit into this category for me. Already in my experience, watches that fit into this category for me have never got to the point where they're not working anymore. In fact, I think they're going to last a lot longer. I do also keep in mind in this category that water tightness. So I'm not going to be taking some swimming, but this is what I think I'm going to do. I'm going to replace those movements or get them serviced, but I'm just going to wait until they get to that point where they basically have to be serviced or have to be replaced. The third category is an interesting one for me because it generally contains watches that have movements from ETA or Sellita. These are probably some of my favorite movements, and they're some of my favorite movements because of the quality of them, how they perform, but also they're still relatively affordable, and they're also easy to have serviced, easy to have parts replaced if required. These watches make up quite a large chunk of my collection at the moment, and these watches that I wear semi-regularly, maybe once a week, maybe once a month, some of them, these are watches that I am going to get serviced, but I'm going to push back that service time. I am going to push that service time to the 7 to 8 year mark. If something goes wrong with them in the interim, if I happen to drop them or something occurs that specifically requires more intervention, well, I will do that. But overall, I'm going to push that servicing back to that later date. For me, that means it's going to be serviced and looked after. For me, I think they should mostly be okay. For me, also then the water tightness, water resistance within that watch should be addressed within a time frame that is okay. The fourth category actually only relates to one watch in my collection at the moment. There may be another one coming into this at some point in the future, and that is these more high-end watches, these more luxury watches, these watches that contain movements that are perhaps thought of as being a little bit more fancy, a little bit more refined. The watch that's in my collection at the moment that fits into this category is my Tudor Black Bay 58. Now, that's not a super high-end movement or a super high-end watch, but it certainly does sort of fit into a category that I think I need to look after it a little bit better. I need to sort of service it a little bit more regularly. And I went to the purchase of that Tudor, and I will go into the purchase of any other watches in this sort of category with the knowledge that I am going to spend that money, with the knowledge that I am going to look after it. So I've gone into it with my eyes open. I've gone into it with my eyes open in regards to price, and I'm going to get that Tudor serviced at the 5 year mark. If I buy other watches, perhaps like a Grand Seiko in the future, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to look after it. And that is sort of what I'm sort of talking about in regards to my feelings about what I'm going to do with all the mechanical watches in my collection. Four separate categories. So I've now got these 17 watches. Some are going to be serviced, some aren't going to be serviced, some are going to be serviced later on, some are definitely going to be serviced. How much are those services going to cost me? Whether that's today, tomorrow, or 10 years in the future, how much am I going to spend on these mechanical movements? Well, I would love to give you an exact figure. I really would. I think it would be great to go, this is how much it is, but I can't, and I can't for two reasons. Firstly, the costs of servicing do differ quite considerably between where you happen to live. Here in Australia, it's actually a little bit expensive. Other parts of the world, it's much cheaper, and there are other parts of the world that's even more expensive. But it also then relates to what's being done to the movement as well. Is it a simple service, or if there's some problems with it, well, it's going to affect the cost. But what I do want to tell you is the three costs that I'm aware of with basic watch services here in Australia. So it may vary considerably depending on where you are. For an ETA-based movement, just a general service with nothing wrong with it, costs around $400 Australian. That's how much just a general service. It does vary a little bit. I've had quotes from $350 up to $600, but $400 tends to be the average amount. If you're talking about a slightly more high-end movement, a friend of mine actually had his Omega service recently, and it cost him $800. That was through Omega, so it was double the price. And it was just a normal service. There weren't anything else added to that. It was just because it was a higher-end movement. Perhaps it was because it was Omega itself, but it was $800 Australian. I've also been putting some time and energy into learning about possibly slightly more fancier movements, slightly more high-end movements, sort of more sort of horology movements, just to get a bit of an understanding of, well, how much does it cost to get those movements serviced? And what I can say is that varies considerably, but what I have found is that the servicing cost for those generally start at about $1,500 Australian, so double again. So it's going to depend a lot for where you are in the world. It's going to cost a lot different depending on what movement it is, and it's going to cost differently depending on what might be wrong or right with the movement. And guys, I'm really interested to get the information from you guys about this. Do you have any more information for me? Do you have any more different experiences with me? What are your thoughts about servicing your own watches? Please leave a comment down below because I am genuinely interested. And after you do that, maybe watch these videos next.